ever hear grown-ups talk about something called a blizzard? Well, what is a blizzard? Well, it's not just a snowstorm. It's like a super-powered snowstorm with some very special rules. So let's find out exactly what a blizzard actually is.
So what causes a blizzard? How do they happen?
Well, imagine a superhero team, but instead of superheroes, we have warm air and cold air joining forces. When they meet, the cold air pushes the warm air up high.
As the warm air rises, it gets chilly, and the water inside turns into tiny ice crystals. These crystals stick together to form snowflakes.
But a blizzard needs more than just snow. It also needs wind. And not just any little breeze. We're talking about a wind that can blow as fast as a car driving down the street. At least 35 miles per hour. In some super strong blizzards, the wind can even blow up to 120 miles per hour. When the wind starts to blow, it can make the snow fly all over the place, even sideways. And during a blizzard, the wind blows the snow around so much it makes it hard to see. This is called low visibility. In fact, the visibility has to be less than a quarter of a mile. This means that you can't see very far. And sometimes it's so hard to see that people call it a whiteout when all you can see is just white.
For a winter storm to be officially called a blizzard, all that snow, wind, and low visibility has to last for at least 3 hours.
And snow has to fall at about 2 or more inches per hour during a blizzard, and winds need to be 35 miles per hour or more.
Blizzards can happen almost anywhere that it snows, but they are most common in the upper Midwest of the United States and the Great Plains because there's a lot of open land for the wind and snow to move around.
Blizzards are no joke. They can be really dangerous, and here's a few reasons why.
Well, the wind and snow can make it very hard to see, so it's dangerous to go outside or drive. People can get stuck in the snow and also run out of supplies like food and water.
The weight of the snow can make trees fall, roofs cave in, and break windows. Power lines can get damaged and people can lose electricity. This can cause people to get too cold.
Blizzards can even hurt crops and animals. But don't worry, there are also ways to stay safe.
If you know a blizzard is coming, you can listen to weather warnings, keep extra food, water, and warm blankets in your car.
And if you're home, stay inside or don't go anywhere. Keep warm with extra blankets and candles if the power goes out.
Scientists try their best to predict blizzards by using radar and satellites.
They look at the wind, temperature, and precipitation to see where a storm might be coming from, but sometimes even the scientists can be surprised.
Surprise!
Blizzards can be amazing and powerful, but it's important to respect their power and stay safe. So when a blizzard rolls up, grab your hot cocoa, stay cozy, and watch as winter puts on its greatest show. So stay safe and let it snow.
Well, hey, guess what? Now we all know just a little bit more about blizzards.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up button. It really helps out our channel.
It sure does.
Make sure you subscribe.
Bye.